هل سمعتم قصة تحكي مجدا بسماها أم رأيتم شعلة شقف الأفق ضياها
هل سمعتم قصة تحكي مجدا بسماها أم رأيتم شعلة شقف الأفق ضياها
هم نجوم سطروا أحلى المعاني وبروج شيدوا الهمة فاني
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي Brothers and sisters in Islam, we're watching ITV networks from all parts of the world, from America, from Europe, from Asia. Welcome to our beautiful and wonderful network in the world, which is called ITV, itvnetworks.tv. And those who are watching from live streaming, where you can get all the information about all our episodes and other presenters. So today we're talking on the topic is called loving yourself. Many times in life, you find human beings, they give up. They give up based on skin color, for example, on their body size. They tend to underrate themselves to say, no, just because I look like this, I don't love myself. I've heard of so many cases, some people even commit suicide because they don't love the way they look. Some people, they don't like the shape of their nose, the shape of their eyes, the shape of their lips, their skin tone. They don't like it. So at the end of the day, they give up. Even hair. Some people don't like their hair. So today, we're going to measure in giving you the ingredients that can change you, that can guide you on how to love yourself. It is said in Surah Imran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبِكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ The meaning of which is, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ That if, say, Muhammad, if you really love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبِكُمُ اللَّهُ Follow me, يُحْبِبِكُمُ اللَّهُ And Allah will love you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ And to forgive all your sins, وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ So here the word love has been mentioned. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ If you love Allah, then follow me. So like that, we as Muslimin and we as human beings must follow the path of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the path of loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the first thing you must always remember before you love yourself is to love Allah, love the Creator, love Almighty God. Brothers and sisters in Islam out there, ask yourself, do I love myself? How is my self-esteem? Some people didn't have high self-esteem. They look down upon themselves, but they are maybe African. Maybe they are black. Maybe they're not white. They tend to look down upon themselves. This is not right. Always embrace high self-esteem. Don't look down, look up. Don't bend your back, sit upright, sit straight. Be confident. Embrace confidence no matter who you are. I've seen a man on a wheelchair. Does not have legs. The legs have been amputated. But the man has got a bright smile, smiling every day. And you won't understand what's happening, but the man does not even have legs. Just imagine, you don't have legs today. What will happen to you? But many people that have legs, they're not confident. You find a man is not blind, but does not have confidence. But a person who is blind has got confidence. So today, brothers and sisters in Islam, and all the viewers of ITV, before you sleep, have what is called a self-examination or a self-test. So this self-test will make you successful each and every day. To gain success, make sure you have the self-test every day. But what is my performance today? Did I love myself? Did I respect myself? Then you'll be successful. So many times, people are underachievers. They don't achieve the best in life because you said, I'm nothing. Be motivated today and love yourself. No one is going to love you except yourself. Everything is you. I know many of you, you're looking at me today. But as you look at me, think about how you love yourself. The way you love yourself is how you're going to go to the next step. To go to the next step in life is how much you love yourself. All successful people, you must ask them, what did you do for you to be successful? The first step was loving myself. But if you're going to not take the first step, this is where you've got a problem. Some people can't take the first step. This is the first step of love, loving what you are. The next day, you've been told you'll be amputated. What you do? The first day you come out of the hospital, you must embrace self-love. Because you know you don't have a leg. And all your friends are going to see you without legs. So embrace what is called self-love to gain confidence in life. The ingredients of loving yourself, what are the ingredients? Also have the aqidah, the faith, all right? The faith must be in you. Embrace what is called God consciousness. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Believe in the monotheism of Islam, of Allah, and also follow the Sirat Mustaqim, the straight path. And trust, tawakkul. Have trust in Allah. Don't trust anybody. Don't depend on anybody, but depend on Allah. Many times, people have no self-love because they depended too much on human beings. A human being can let you down. They say, the many problems you have, the less friends you have. Today you've got problems, all your friends run away. But Allah does not run away from you. So if you really love yourself, stay away from being addicted or actually confiding the whole entire life of yours to human beings. Human beings disappoint you. No one will ever give you 100% love except Almighty Allah. He said the Creator, Almighty God. And your food and drink, watch out. You know that you really love yourself, watch out what you eat. You can't tell me you love yourself when you take drugs. You can't tell me you love yourself when you drink alcohol. You can't tell me you love yourself when you, for example, you want to commit suicide. Every time and again, you want to shoot yourself, you want to drink some pills and kill yourself. That is not self-love. Self-love, you watch what you eat. You watch what you drink. That is self-love. And remember what you said, health is wealth. And halal is halal. And haram is haram. Where is your wealth coming from? Look at it. You're a drug addict and you're a drug dealer. And you could tell me you love yourself. What if you end up in prison? You can't tell me that you're robbing banks and you call yourself you love yourself. You can't tell me that you are actually a thug and you say you love yourself. So watch where your money is coming from. Because sometimes you end up in bad consequences such that you will never love yourself again. Because you end up in serious situations that you cannot come back again. So the first point and the main point that you must understand about loving yourself is watching where your money comes from. And education or information. Check where your information is coming from. Some people have no self-love because why? They saw on social media that not loving yourself is the main thing. That you must always follow the trends. Well, celebrities wear, you must wear that. No. Because a celebrity has got an expensive car. You go to bank and borrow money. At the end of the day, the bank, you owe them and you got a big credit. You can't pay it. You end up not loving yourself. That I got a big problem. I'm stressed. I have to pay 10,000 per month for the Lamborghini or the Bugatti. It's your fault. So some of these things, they make you not to love yourself. You put yourself in a risky situation. How to attain or gain self-love? The first thing is always to advise also. Man ra'a minkum munkaran falyughayyir biyadihi aw bilisanihi, all right? Aw biqalbihi, walakin adhafa al-iman. That whoever see a person doing wrong, advise. So by you being an advisor, that means you are revising good deeds. Brothers in Islam, whoever see a munkar or an evil deed, try to control with your hand, with your tongue, all right, or your heart. But that is weakness of iman. Make sure that you don't leave everybody doing wrong. Like your friends, they're doing wrong, say yes, do wrong. Your neighbors do wrong, Allah. Because at the end of the day, you'll be surrounded by wrong people. So how are you going to get self-love when you've got wrong friends? As you know, brothers and sisters in Islam, there's a lot of peer pressure out there. So for you to change, you need to be surrounded by positive people, by right-minded people, by inspirational people, by motivational people. So embrace change also. If you're doing wrong, to gain good self-love, you have to also change. If you're taking drugs, stop drugs. If you're drinking alcohol, stop drinking alcohol. If you don't have an education, get an education. If you're not given good health, start to jog around and to exercise your body. That will harness self-love. And the truth. Do not hide the truth at all. Because the truth always manifests. Mistake that happen in the world that these days, people don't tell the truth. They're always lying. So part of self-love is by you staying away from negative or wrong information. Try also to do da'wah. Try also to talk about Islam, talk about good deeds, talk about humbleness. In that way, your life and the people around you will start to change. And another point is, even to Christians, have a positive attitude. Don't ever have a negative attitude because you've met a certain type of people. Try to always embrace a positive attitude each and every day. That will make you to what? To have real self-love. Another point you have to remember is that many people, they end up even committing what is called suicide. Why? It is because these people are people that don't love themselves. Because the person who really loves himself will never do that. And it's haram for human being to what? To commit suicide. They do not love themselves. They do not rely on Allah. So if you rely on a human being, you're always going to have problems. So always also embrace this world if you need good self-love. The word love. L-O-V-E. Embrace love. Love paradise. All right? Do not kill yourself. All right? Also, love your deen. Love to fulfill promises. Embrace love and true love. Don't have this fake love. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we're taking a short break, inshallah. All of you must relax, drink a Coke, drink a cappuccino, and also try to drink what is right. Anyway, Coke is an acidic drink. But try to drink what is right and make sure you are patient. And come back to listen to a beautiful topic which is called loving yourself. It will motivate you, it will change your life. Brothers in Islam, welcome back to a beautiful topic today which is called love yourself. Brothers in Islam, how many people have neglected themselves? They don't care about who they are. They don't cherish their looks. How many people? So many people in this world, they don't love to change themselves. So today, change your life. Tell yourself that I will change. And make dua. Pray to Allah. Wake up for Fajr Salah. Wake up anytime and pray that, Creator, Ya Allah, I want to change. I want to embrace change. I want to love myself. And also, do not kill yourself, as we said, prior to taking this next segment. We talked about how to love yourself, how to care for yourself. Brothers and sisters in Islam, many people commit suicide in this world because they don't love themselves. Society will tell you that you must dress in this way. So if you don't dress in this way, then you are liable to be looked down upon. Society will tell you only wear certain type of shoes. Only dress this way. Look glossy. Look lovely. This is the only way in life. This is true success. Society is based on materialism. So you, if you want to be successful, do not listen to society. Listen to the Creator, Almighty Allah Azza Jal. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when you see the celebrities looking glossy, I know the celebrities look glossy, they look lovely. This is what we want. We don't want to what? To follow the teachings of Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, who says go with moderation. Ummatan wasata. Our ummah or our nation is a nation of moderation. So the more moderate you are as a Muslim today, the more you are at peace. So if you're not moderate, you're extreme, you want to go with the society, then you're not going to love yourself. Brothers in Islam, society will tell you, have plastic surgery. It reminds me of a brother. He had plastic surgery. Plastic surgery of his nose, put plastic surgery. Then when the nose was falling, he started to regret. One person spent thousands of dollars on plastic surgery. His face now is like it's falling. You know, this plastic surgery is also wrong things can happen. You know, the doctor maybe might be experimenting. So they've no 100% guarantee that your plastic surgery, either for the breast or for the face or for anything, any of your body organ, will be 100%. So the plastic surgery is fake. At the end of the day, how many people have wasted money on plastic surgery? Brothers in Islam, don't be fooled by what you see on TV. Some of the information on TV is just mass media, just to take you for a ride. It's not reality. So sometimes the celebrity, they put makeup. They call it camera, they call it filter. They filter it. And at the end of the day, it's not reality. So you follow what is you think is positive, but it's not positive. So brothers in Islam, if you want to enhance how you love yourself, don't follow whatever you see on TV. TV is TV. So what I'm trying to say to you is that you yourself, you got all the ingredients of change to the fact that you can end up loving yourself too much. Don't always look for Brazilian hair. Don't look for the Peruvian hair, Malaysian hair. Love the hair that you got. This reminds me of this story. One sister, she bought fake hair because she doesn't love herself. Then there was a big crowd. The fake hair fell down. And the face hair were different. Everyone was laughing at her. So what I'm asking you as a viewer today, would you want to be in this situation of the sister who was wearing fake hair? At the end of the day, people were laughing at her. No. We know it's not right as a Muslim to laugh at other human beings. But we're talking of a circumstance whereby you look funny when you put fake hair. Love what you are. I'm not saying the sister should not look beautiful. Some people say, hey, this sheikh is very hard. No. A woman should look lovely, beautiful. You know? Beautiful and you know, you see, this sister is beautiful. Alhamdulillah. My wife is beautiful. Even a man must look handsome. A man must even groom himself. So anyway, many people, they spend thousands of rand every month on hair alone. Someone will say, I'll go to Brazil. I'll buy a ticket flight to Brazil, 12,000 rand. And then in Brazil, I'm going to buy fake hair. Flying from OR Tambo to what? To Brazil. Rio de Janeiro, just to buy hair. Brothers in Islam, that person is also, if you look at it, does not have enough money. Just to try to please society. Say, no, I want to please the TV. I want to look like the Bollywood star. I want to look like a star from Hollywood and Nollywood. No. As a Muslim, love what you are. They were talking about the grave of a person who is from Kuwait. The person had over 20 wells of oil. He was a very rich person. But when he died, kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut, every human being is going to taste death. His grave was very simple. So in the world, live a simple life and love yourself. Your grave also will be simple. So brothers in Islam and teachers in Islam, let us understand that there are also sisters out there. They're bleaching their skin. You're bleaching your skin for what reason? Love the way your skin tone is. This is a gift from the Creator Almighty Allah. So you have the self-love in order to what? To take care of your body. How to see that you really love yourself? How to see? Test yourself. When you hear the words of Allah, do you cry? Some people, when they hear the news in the gossip tabloid, they don't cry. I mean, they don't cry, they're happy. But when the words of the Creator read, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, doesn't touch their hearts. But whenever they hear hip-hop music or rock music, they are so happy. You know? They don't appreciate the words of the Creator. So this is how to test, do you really love yourself? Because if you love yourself, you would love the holy words, not the satanic words. So brothers in Islam, let us be mindful that some of the situations in the universe that people push us to the what? To the path of Shaitan. So if you really love yourself, make sure you love what is right. And when you miss your prayers, do you cry? Some people, when they miss a bus, or they miss a soccer match, Manchester United versus Chelsea, they start to cry, tears. But when they miss their prayers, no, I miss my prayers, no problem. I'm going to see it next year. How you know you're going to see next year? Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. Anything can happen to you. The story of Joseph, peace be upon him, we call him Yusuf in Arabic, does it touch your heart? These are the stories of people that were downtrodden, thrown in the world by his brothers. Jealousy from his brothers, hate from his brothers, but he became a president of Egypt due to self-love. He loved himself. Yusuf alayhi salam said in this dua, "Tawaffani musliman walhiqni bis-salihin," that my Lord, cause me to die as a Muslim and also bring me, or resurrect me, or make me to join the righteous people. Today, because you don't love yourself, you want to be with the thugs. See, I got a lot of friends. What type of friends? They're top-notch drug lords. My friend, they smoke cigarettes. They're chain smokers. They actually smoke any cigar you want from the world. My friend, they're top-notch gossipers. How can you say you love yourself and your friends are top-notch gossipers? Your friends are top-notch drug addicts or chain smokers. This is not self-love. Because at the end of the day, a chain smoker, what does he give you? Because visiting a chain smoker, we can give you this analogy. It's like visiting a person who's got selling perfume and a person who's a chain smoker. From the perfume seller, you get nice smell. And from the chain smoker, you get this smoke smell. So at the end of the day, this is not good for you to visit a chain smoker. Rather visit a person who's what? Who is selling perfume. Because that shows that you really love yourself. Ways to improve how you love yourself. Act upon your words. Yeah, Allah SWT says in the Quran, بَعْدَ أَوْذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ That all you who believe in the monotheism of Islam, do not say what you don't do. Some people say, I'm a Muslim. No, I'm a Muslim. But the word Islam means peace. But you're cruel to the whole world. You don't laugh. You don't even smile. You don't even talk good words. So how you call yourself a person who loves himself when you can't even talk nice to Christians? You can't talk nice to Hindu people. You can't talk nice to Jews. Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam spoke nice to Jews when he was giving dawah to them. He spoke nice even to Christians when he was giving dawah to them. So part of self-love is to have sweet words. Al-kalimatu tayyiba sadaqa. And practice what you preach. Never be close to suicide. Avoid drugs. Improve each and every day. Never stop trying. Think about the importance of time each and every day. Life is too short to stress. Remember that time is money. Wal asri innal insana fi khusr. By the token of time, man is at loss. Illa alladhina amanu wa amilus salihat wa tasabbahu haqq wa tasabbahu sabr. By the token of time, man is at loss. Today you're wasting your time on not loving yourself. You are from those people that what? Are at loss. So if you want enrichment in your life, make sure that as a Muslim, value your time and love yourself. Loving yourself, brother in Islam, today will change everything about you. Whether Allah has made your body to be very big, get up and say, I am. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me. All right? I love myself. Whether you're dark and they call you ugly, say, no, I don't mind you calling me ugly. I'm beautiful. I'm handsome. Whether I don't have Brazil hair, tell them, my hair, I love it, and I love myself. Whether you can't walk, whether you're on a wheelchair, whether you don't have shoes, whatever circumstance you are in, whether you're poor, whether you're rich, love yourself. Love yourself. Brothers and sisters out there, love yourself. Embrace self-love. Learn to love yourself. Learn how to love. May Allah make it easy for us as Muslimin to love ourselves each and every day. Never ever to put plastic surgery on our face and to put fake hair on our heads. We must always embrace self-love and always keep our bodies healthy and exercise each and every day. May Allah make it easy for us to keep this good health, because health is wealth. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
سمعتم قصة تحكي مجدا بسماها أم رأيتم شعلة شقف الأفق ضياها هم نجوم سطروا أحلى المعاني وبروج شيدوا الهمة فانين.